The juice is loose. UC Staros getting his first home start of the year, looking to get in the win column.
Everly into the high slot, gets the return feed. Nelson steers it over. Diving block by Watson. We saw that a couple of times last night, where he blocked six shots. Another shot, Staros, and it got through the five hole. Power play goal for the Islanders. And they have the early 1-0 lead. Lead on a bounce by the Islanders over to their bench. Now Bailey looks up ice. Islanders crisscross at the blue line. Bailey moves in, sidestep to defender, feeds it across. Great save by Staros. Staros, cat quick.
You see Anders Lee trying to go upstairs like we talked about. UC Staros gets over there and takes it off the shoulder. Excellent save by UC Staros on that one.
Hit off the puck by Boteto. Boteto fresh out there. Two men coming out of the box. It's back to five aside. Pull off, let it fly. Another save for Staros. And they turn the tables on the Chicago Blackhawks. Barzal curling. Circles back. Makes a great feed in front, and Staros makes a huge save. Fiala retrieves the puck. Blast by Sisson. Fought off by Halak. Rebound controlled by New York. Back to the line, a quick play to Fiala. Fiala turns the corner, shoots. Rebound, Forsberg. He scores! The Predators come out of the gate in the second and tie the score, and it's number 9 again. Number 8 on the season.
Philip Forsberg, our Mr. October, breaks the Nashville Predators' October record for goals scored with 8. Ties the game.
Good stick by Gaudreau. And now the Predators come back in with numbers. Hartnell has a lane, a blast, and a close save by Halak with Smith following up. Ladd now engages with Webb. Open man to Hahn. Tees up the wrist, could get the shot away. Curls back, and a big save by Staros with the pad on Chimera. The clearing attempt deflected off of an Islander player. Now here comes Josi. Josi cuts middle and shoots on the backhand, stopped by Halak.
It goes back the other way, and you have to kill a penalty.
Marcel took his hand off of his stick, and now they score. So the Islanders immediately cash in, and Boteto is still hot.
Islanders win the draw, get it back. It'll go right back to the middle, and just a blast. I think they had a screen there up at the top. You see, UC Staros doesn't see it till late. Right in the upper portion of the net, right inside the post.
Indeed.
And that stings. That stings when you get a penalty like that.
Regardless of what he did to draw that penalty, he has been a handful tonight. He can move. Here's Tavares. Off for Letty. Save made by Staros. Rebound. Chip just wide. Tavares takes it again. Behind the net, Forsberg. Forsberg trying to wiggle free. Crosses and drops. Ekholm to the dot. Shoots. The rebound deflected just wide. Oh my goodness, pinball action. Flip down ice. Here comes Watson. Steamboating into the players. Popped the puck free. Now cuts to the net. Looked like he got held up by a stick there. Crowd wanted a penalty. Now here's Johansson shooting. Rebound in front. Fighting for it, Watson. They jam in it a second time. Salamaki got a chance. That's stopped by Halak.
Johansson beat it. Austin Watson getting all kinds of hooks there. But just a tenacious shift by this line. All over the New York Islanders. They had about a minute of possession. Good for the Corsi stats in there, but just great work by those three. Really getting after simple hockey.
Gaudreau back for Hartnell. Right in front. Pass deflected. Boteto was cutting right down the middle. He was open. Now on the counterattack. Islanders have numbers. Barzal to Everly. Save Staros. And the rebound, they score.
And they come back. There was a little miscommunication on the coverage there. And it just squeaks through UC Staros. His arm behind the net and in the back of the net. And that's a tough break with 30 seconds left in this period. Predators did get their chances, so there'll be some there this period as well.
Peter Laviolette shook up the line combinations in the second period. And once again, it'll be Colton Sissons working with Kevin Fiala and Philip Forsberg. And right off the bat, a bad bounce. Caroms right over to John Tavares. And just like that, 12 seconds in, it's 4-1 New York.
Well, if you could think of the worst possible start to a period,
That's got to be it. And then a missed shot right on the stick of Johnny Tavares. I don't know if he got that one or not, but what a terrible sequence of bad bounces.
Just joining us, Predators trailed 1-0 at the end of one, tied it up on Philip Forsberg's 8th goal of the year. There's Eberle working it low. What a play by Ekholm. Now jamming at it. Tavares off the post and in. It's 5-1.
This is another horrible bounce for UC Soros because I think it was going wide and actually went off, I think, Kelly Yarncroke's left skate and deflected in the net. We'll see right here. Keep an eye on Kelly Yarncroke back door here. The puck just caroms right off of his skate. Man, a couple awful bounces to start this period.
Tavares for the high tip to Bailey. Stick was tied up last moment. Barzal circles. Shown some dynamic skating tonight. And Tavares scores. The third power play goal of the night for the Islanders, and it is a 6-1 hockey game.
And the Islanders' power play has really decided to come to life tonight because excellent puck movement, different looks, and then Johnny Tavares, just a laser beam right up and over top corner of the net. You see the right there. Oh, man. What a shot. Can't catch a break here tonight.
Right under the bar. Mateto leaves it for Freddie Gaudreau. Nice pass. Predators coming in 2-on-1. Weber has Craig Smith. Weber shot. Glove by Halak. Halak making it look easy on his end. And he turns away another Predator chance.
And Halak has been very good tonight.
As Subban clears the remains of his stick off to the corner. Subban wants it again. Top of the circle. The wrister in front. Tipped on the way in by Hartnell. Saved by Halak. Boychuk had a long talk with the referee during the TV timeout, saying, hey, I thought that was a bad hit, etc. Predators get a power play out of it. They're 0-for-3 tonight. They've threatened the last couple of times. Here's Josi. Let's it go! And it was tipped by Hartnell, hit the outside of the net. Josi trying to get it back to Subban. It was deflected. Now he returns it to PK. Subban finds Josi up high. He'll let it fly. It was juggled by Halak, and he smothered it before the Predators could get to the rebound. Join some of the Predators players. It is a good time. I've never been there. Loose puck behind the net. Predators scrambling for it. Still on the power play here. Smith works it high. Ekholm back for Craig Smith and tees it up. He scores! It's a power play goal for Craig Smith. Back-to-back goals in as many nights.
Just unleashes another wrister. This is why Peter Laviolette says when he's playing fast and he's shooting the puck, he's playing his best hockey. And Craig Smith gets on the board for the second game in a row. And that's a good sign for the Predators moving forward.
There is a good confidence boost for number 15. He's an important player. Long term. Arvidsson. Straight away. Weber. Save made by Halak. Another save with the glove by Yaroslav Halak.
Well, it's tough because we didn't see them at first glance, you know, and then we saw the replays. We have the luxury of the replay. And the ref's got to make that real time, and
that's
it depends
hard.
What angle, so it's tough.
So that will do it. The Islanders get the victory tonight, 6-2 over the Nashville Predators. So Nashville splits the back-to-back, so win in Chicago last night, a loss here tonight at Bridgestone Arena. So the Predators will regroup for a couple of days and then head out to San Jose to start the California road trip on Wednesday night against the Sharks.